I want to, Bahar, bring you back in again with a question, which is around, you know, I'm an entrepreneur interested in investing time in the building some kind of solution. And, you know, one of the things that always hits entrepreneurs or innovators is either they don't have the right amount of support, funding support, or they don't have the right amount of access to tools and that they can use to experiment, because it can be very expensive to really at early stages. But one thing that can stop you in your tracks is when you feel there's a huge amount of regulation that, you know, even if you have the money and have the tools and access to advice, the regulation will stop you from being successful. In your experience working with startups, what's the biggest thing that you have noticed that we may put on the table for our great colleagues over here who are working in government to have on top of their mind to enable a healthy startup ecosystem in healthcare?
Thank you, Mr. Mohammed Seer, for addressing this type of questions. To be honest, us being working with early stage startups and operating startups, funding, yes, it's a big issue. However, we do help them in using methods such as bootstrapping and so on and so forth. So for us, it's viable to guide and mentor those early stage startups into a business model that would generate revenue from an early stage. So this is one aspect that we make sure that we help our early stage entrepreneurs in addressing. When it comes to tools, I do agree that early stage tools for entrepreneurs to be used, it's a bit expensive. However, we see today a lot of entities that are coming in and providing these tools for a discounted period and a free period. So this is an element to be addressed in the tools that could be used by early stage entrepreneurs. When it comes to regulation, this is a very interesting topic. When it comes to AI and big data, as we've seen, there was no entity responsible for that. So thank you, Sadaya, for being here and addressing all the regulatory framework that will be in the future. When it comes today, we haven't seen an startup that want to get into the space. When it comes to data, well, let's separate it in two elements. So if an early stage startup found a champion private sector that would like to use the data and enable that, the private sector will open the door for them. However, it's very difficult for early stage entrepreneurs without a track record and a history to knock the door on one of the biggest universities, which they have a health center, or to knock the doors one of the ministries, which they have a health center. This is very difficult because there is no regulation when it comes to accessing those data yet. There is no way to commercialize it, so it's very difficult to give it to them. However, if they found a champion from the private sector, it's very possible to be addressed. Yeah. When it comes to private sector, there is always different sizes. So if you are an early stage entrepreneur, don't go to world-class health hospital. Start with a small clinic in place that you can enable them with your solutions. Once you address a couple of those in place, then you can go to a medium-sized clinic. Once you achieve that, then you can go to a bigger clinic. And even when you go talk to investors, coming back to the funding, even when you go back to investors, well, going to investor with an idea is different than going to investor with a track record that you served several clinics, even if they were small, but you show a potential. So we do address that by telling those early stage entrepreneurs, look at the bigger picture. At the end, you want to serve these hospitals, but for you to start, you have to address small clinics, private clinics, one-man clinic, one-doctor clinic. Then you serve a bigger clinic. Once you do that and you get the trust of the private sector, then you can knock doors on bigger entities in place. So I think entrepreneurs have to be realistic what to address. Their power, their pitch depend on what they have addressed in capabilities before. So we advise early stage entrepreneurs to take it from different perspective. Test your business model with smaller clinic. Once you achieve that, then you can go to bigger clinics and so on and so forth.